Beauregard, welcome to Merthyr Twist. We are now taking you back in time to Merthyr 1830, a time where young children went to the workhouse.
Alright, back those things.
I'm sad, son. My mum passed away, so I'm off to the workhouse.
So I'd hear that, George, all the best.
Oliver started his journey through Merthyr, passing a red house and Cavartha Castle on his way to the workhouse. He goes on to meet Mr. Bumble, a ruthless man.
Hurry up, boy! The workhouse is waiting! I'm gonna give you the name, Oliver Twist!
But my name was Jack, sir.
You belong to me now, boy!
Oliver arrived at the workhouse and heard screams, cries and shouting. He was scared, as any child would be.
Follow me, boy! Take off your nightcoat and put them rags on! You're a boy! You're at the workhouse now!
What do I have to do in the workhouse?
You'll soon see, boy!
Oliver joins the other orphans at Thomastown Workhouse. His life is about to take an unexpected turn. I wonder how it will end for him.
Set in the Union Workhouse in Thomastown, Merthyr Tydfil, a boy called Oliver is left to live and work in a workhouse. Work was hard and the children had very little food.
Oh,
bumble takes all of us to the evil eye master Richard Crawshay.
Well, we are back in the middle of the Dowlais Dodger!
Dowlais soldiers take over the Fagin entirely at Dowlais' top to meet the Fagin.
Our business is often more better. Our blood wins the war on trees. You've got to pick a pocket or two. You've got to pick a pocket or two. Boys, you've got to pick a pocket or two.
Pleasure.
Dallas.
I have to go without things.
Anywhere! Because he even knew for me is getting work and I've been lying around here all day.
Yeah, you're right. Now listen, Oliver, you be careful. But it's going to be a very scary place. So tell you what!
Bye!
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 Bye! Bye! Bye!
Oh,
strong men. Trembling when they hear it. They've got cause about to fear it. It's much blacker than the spirit. Nobody riches. Nobody can rich men. Holy God, I'm not sad. Such negative little concept. They know I can tell a frozen out. Just to live up to my name.
Introduces Oliver to Dr. Grimwick.
He
He's a fine boy, don't you think, Grimwig?
Come to where he came from.
I haven't the faintest idea. A shopkeeper told me the real story, and he was released from court.
Nonsense. Now that you'll shut stop only once and you'll do it again. I'll tell you what, why don't you let Oliver return those books back for you today?
Yes, sir. Please let me take them for you, sir.
Very well. And Dr. Grimwig, I'm sure you will be pleased when he arrives back in 10 minutes.
Right.
Oliver makes his way to Merthyr Town to take the books back for Mr. Brownlow when in town he bumped into old friends.
Indeed.
the Bumbles sees his opportunity to make some money off someone's misfortune.
I understand you bring information regarding a boy. All in a trace.
We come in answer to your efforts, but this locket was given to me by the last I mother just before she passed away.
Why? It's just Agnes, my daughter. Did she get any hope of profiting from this locket?
Sir, considering this trinket didn't probably belong to us, how about you, Annet?
Here, £10, and consider yourself fortunate that I did not hand you over to the police.
Pardon me, sir.
I have room for all of us. He's in danger, faculty or Fagin, and I wish I was never part of it.
Who is this Fagin?
I can't tell you, but I promise I will bring it to you. I will be on the Kevin Road at between 11 and the time the clock strikes 12.
Very well.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we have your appreciation for a marvellous cast on Merthyr Twist?
Anywhere for your smile. And before we finish, I really want to say a huge thank you to all of the staff. They've worked incredibly hard. There are some staff who have gone over and above and worked incredibly hard, so we're going to do some special thank yous. So, where is Keisha? Keisha, can you help me? So, Mr. Carr, in the control room there. Big thanks to Mr. Carr. So, Deanna's going to help me to say a big thank you to Isaac Eaton on the lights.
Yeah.
Bumble, old Sally has got something to tell that must be heard.
In this very workhouse, I once nursed a young lady who I brought in from the cold. She gave birth to a boy and died. I took her gold locket. I believe she came from a very rich family.
The boy's name?
Oliver.
We must retrieve that boy, Mr. Bumble.
We must indeed, ma'am. We must indeed.
Our senses are reeling. One moment.